The first methods of medicine weren't ibuprofen and morphine. They were herbs and plants. So today, why do we mostly rely on ibuprofen and other pain medications to relieve our pain? Why do we have to do it that way versus doing the more natural ways? Today, I want to inform you about ways to manage pain and find relief outside of medication. Everyone in this room has experienced pain at some point in their life. I'm sure everyone's probably injured themselves, whether they broke an arm or stubbed their toe. Either way, you got some kind of pain. I live with chronic neck and shoulder pain from a bad car accident I was in a few years ago, and I have come to very much dislike pain medication. So I've spent the last couple years finding ways to relieve my pain without taking pain medications. Today, I'll tell you about common pain medications and their side effects, how pain can be managed by movement, and some services that are available here in Faribault to help with pain management. First, I'm going to talk about the most common pain medications and their side effects. The pain medications that you are probably most familiar with are these. They're called over-the-counter pain medications. That basically means that they are available to pretty much anyone, anywhere. You don't need a prescription from your doctor. They're just probably what you have the most familiarity and experience with. According to GoodRx.com, ibuprofen, naproxen, and acetaminophen are the top three over-the-counter pain meds. They all pretty much do the same thing. They help relieve mild pain, whether that's coming from inflammation or a fever. A lot of these things are found in cold medicines as well. They all have pretty much very similar side effects. They all lead to kidney damage. For example, if you took Tylenol every day for months consecutively, you risk damaging your kidney function. Other ones have some other side effects like stomach issues that can be mild as indigestion or as serious as ulcers, and some of them will even cause you liver damage if you take them with alcohol. So I don't like over-the-counter pain medications very much, and they tend to not work for me. So I went to my doctor and I got a prescription medication, and I learned a lot about those as well. Prescription medications, their strengths vary a lot more than over-the-counter, but the most popular type of prescription medication is opioids. What opioids do is they block the nerve signals that is telling your brain you're in pain, and they replace those pain signals with signals of pleasure. And so their strengths vary. A more mild one, for example, would be codeine. People usually get codeine after they have some dental work done. It's a little bit stronger than Tylenol or anything you can get over the counter, but it's not super strong or it's going to make you feel like you're out of it. One of the strongest opioids out there is fentanyl, and people usually only get that if they are on their deathbed from cancer or an illness that will cause them to die. Almost all opioids have similar side effects of constipation, dizziness, drowsiness, itching or sweating. They cause depression, and they also attack your immune system. So they might be making you feel better by relieving your pain, but they make you more susceptible to hundreds of thousands of other diseases. But probably the most serious side effect of opioids and prescription medications is addiction, which leads to abuse and death. According to drugabuse.gov, 21 to 29% of patients that were prescribed opioids for pain lead to misuse of those. And every day, 130 people in the United States die after abuse of opioids. They overdose on their prescription medications. So because of all of that, I very much dislike pain meds, and I found other ways to manage pain. And one of the simplest things you can do is just move. Chronic pain can be managed by consistently moving the muscles that are causing the pain. So one of the simplest things you can do is just stretch. You can stretch almost any time of day, anywhere. It's very simple, easy. There's lots of resources out there to learn how to do it, what you should be doing, where you should be doing it. Things that you should remember to do when you are stretching is to move slowly. If you move too fast, you risk tearing your muscles, causing yourself more pain. Hold your stretches for 30 to 45 seconds. Do it at least once a day, and you should try to stretch throughout your entire body, not just one spot. The hardest thing about stretching is remembering to do it. After stretching increases oxygen and blood flow throughout your body, which in turn reduces inflammation and reduces pain. On top of stretching, stretching, a consistent workout schedule can be very helpful. It doesn't necessarily have to be spending an hour in the gym every day. It could be a weekly yoga class, it could be swimming, it could be running. Just as long as you're moving, you're using your body and your muscles, and you're doing it somewhat consistently. According to spineuniverse.com, regular exercise keeps joints moving well, keeps muscles strong, your mental health well, and keeps you at a healthy weight, which all in turn can relieve, you know, pain that you deal with every day. And Dr. John Hoover, a sports care physician at Ortho Carolina, says exercise improves pain threshold. With chronic pain, threshold drops. Less pain takes less pain to feel more uncomfortable. Strengthening and flexibility exercise improves that pain threshold. Regular activity can help you not have to worry so much about the pain and still have energy left for enjoying recreational activities. So basically, it's saying that chronic pain is, it eventually lowers your pain threshold, and if you exercise your body, if you teach your muscles how to, you teach your muscles that they don't have to be in pain all the time, they won't be. When your body is injured, your nerves send signals to your brain saying that it's in pain, so then your muscles then react and they constrict to protect that part of your body. So if you're consistently moving your muscles in ways they're not necessarily always used to, you're teaching them to relax, you're teaching them to go back to their normal cycle of constriction and relaxation and so forth. So I've talked about the medications and movement, and finally we will turn to services available here in Faribault that can help you relieve pain. So there are services here in Faribault to help with pain management. One of the things that's been very helpful is physical therapy. Lots of people who are injured or had just come out of a surgery or something like that, their first step is physical therapy. Physical therapy is a branch of rehabilitative health that uses specially designed exercise and equipment to help patients regain or improve physical abilities. So your physical therapist basically teaches your muscles how to work the right way again. They maybe help move your muscles in ways that you wouldn't think of doing to help them relearn. The other thing a physical therapist will do is they'll teach you why your body is reacting to certain things the way it is. They'll teach you about what muscles are causing you problems, what nerves are causing you problems, and kind of why they're doing that, so you are more educated to be able to help yourself outside of being with this specialist as well. Most physical therapists take clients upon referral from a doctor, and they all mostly accept health insurance as well. And in Faribault, there are at least 4 physical therapy clinics that you can go to. Other than physical therapy, massage is also another great technique. Harvard Medical School says therapeutic massage may relieve pain by way of several mechanisms, including relaxing painful muscles, tendons, and joints, relieving stress and anxiety, and possibly helping to close the pain gate by stimulating competing nerve fibers and varying degrees of pressure. So what that means is a massage therapist can take other nerves and kind of use those to overpower the ones that are telling your body that that part is in pain. For someone that has very tense muscles and chronic pain from that, they would probably choose to get a deep tissue massage. A deep tissue massage is where the massage therapist will apply large amounts of pressure and they'll use longer, slower strokes when they're agitating your muscles. In Faribault, there are more than 10 massage therapists, so they all vary on what type of massage they offer, their availability, their pricing, and so on. And another thing that's available is an infrared sauna. An infrared sauna uses light to create heat and then directly heats your body versus the typical sauna that you might see like at a hotel or something. That's probably the most popular place I've seen them. They heat the air in the room and then in turn that heats your body. An infrared sauna uses light directly to heat your body, which is far more effective in what a sauna is designed to do, basically. So an infrared sauna has 3 levels. Near infrared basically just kind of taps into the surface a little bit. Its main effect is surface. It just kind of helps fight against aging. The mid-infrared goes a little bit deeper and it fights inflammation. And then there's far infrared, which most infrared saunas have the far infrared in them. That goes the deepest into your muscles and it reduces pain and draws toxins out of your body. And there are at least 3 places in Faribault that offer infrared saunas that you can pay to. You buy sessions, so whether they're 30 minutes, 60 minutes, 90 minutes, and you can go sit in that sauna and reap its benefits. So in conclusion, I have told you about the most common pain medications, both over-the-counter prescription along with their side effects. I've talked about how movement can help reduce pain and services that are available in Faribault to help find relief and manage pain. I hope that you have learned that there are many ways outside of medication to find pain relief. Yeah.